Hello, everyone. My name is Austin Wagger, and I'm a senior advisory analyst on the AI research team here at Infotech. It's my pleasure to welcome you to our ongoing series in which we highlight the use cases that are driving AI. And today, we are lucky enough to be joined by the team over at Athix. We have Paolo Maserani, the managing director, and David Krika, the pre-sales and business process manager. Thanks to you both for taking the time to join us here today.
Thank you, Austin, for inviting us. It's a pleasure to talk to you here.
Likewise, we're really looking forward to doing a deeper dive into Athix and your artificial intelligence solutions. So with that, maybe I can just ask you to tell us a little bit about your organization.
Of course, with a big pleasure. So Athix is an organization that started operation back in 2018. We are kind of a mature organization that developed two solutions. We are focused on artificial intelligence specifically, and we cover two areas. One is conversational AI, and the other one is emotion AI. And we observed the market, and there were some issues and critical problems to be solved for clients related to the ability to maintain a good relationship with the ecosystem of people and companies usually businesses have to deal with. This is just to mention a few, maybe clients, of course, maybe prospects, but also partners, consultants, employees. So all this ecosystem needs to be addressed in the proper way, and a company cannot keep up with the pace of growth that these relations and requests of information are at. So conversational AI and emotion AI can really give an help here. We are an Italian company, and we're focused on cognitive science, and we have the vision to make innovation accessible to everyone so that every businesses and company can achieve their most higher potential in the business they do. So this is what we do.
So just expanding on that a bit, I know you mentioned that you're focusing on letting businesses and companies kind of achieve the highest potential. With that, how would you describe the value that Athix is able to provide to your clients?
Well, it's not a single value, but I would start saying that we really enable the relationship between companies and their counterparts. And as I said, can be clients, partners, or employees. And we do that by making it very simple using artificial intelligence technologies, which are very complicated. So what we did, it was to create a platform where anyone, any business person, so not necessarily IT or data scientists or developers, so anyone in the organization can go there, jump in it, and start creating its own specific artificial intelligence solution. Few example, for conversational AI, you can jump on our platform and create your chatbot. And this is a chatbot that, of course, leverages on generative AI. So it's very smart, is an experience similar to ChatGPT, but without the risks of ChatGPT. Well, it's kind of recent news of the Air Canada issue with a client that received an information from ChatGPT chatbot from Air Canada, and actually the judge gave and obliged Air Canada to pay because of what the chatbot said to the client. So it's kind of binding what the chatbot say. So what we do is making risk-free this kind of technology and making it simple. So anyone can, with a few information, maybe a web page site, or maybe a small page of frequently asked questions or a value proposition, create its own chatbot. On the other hand, we help clients to predict how people will behave. This is kind of very interesting and very new. We have an area which covers the emotion AI technologies, which enables clients to really predict how people will behave. What does it mean? It means that in real time, we're able to detect psycho-attitudinal traits in a person, the interlocutor, and the person we're talking to, that may be on the phone, maybe an email that they send to you, etc. And we can detect these traits, and putting all these traits together, we can easily predict how these people will behave. Example, if you are a lazy person and not innovative and maybe low spending, it's a very low risk that you will abandon a subscription service. Even if you are not happy, etc., it's very low percentage of probability that you will abandon that. If you are a very innovative person, maybe again, low spending, so similar, but with very eclectic and innovative attitude, then the risk that you will be changing, so your risk of churn is very high. So maybe the company can put in place some retention actions to keep the client ahead and to avoid that this client is, you know, evaluating options to abandon your service and go with maybe a competitor. And you can apply this to marketing. You can apply this to customer service. You can apply this to HR. Very, very good and very, very fitting. And HR example is like mapping the competencies in terms of soft skill of your employee population. So maybe you want to create a training program that fits the gaps your employees have. Then you can really map all your skills of your employees and then create a specific and customized program that perfectly fits the gap you are having in your organization. Example, maybe gaps in working together, team building, gaps in terms of taking decisions and decision making, gaps in terms of managing stress. So if you are aware of what your company lacks in terms of soft skill, then you can operate and you can kind of put a program in place to avoid that this lack, this gap may affect your business. So this is the way we work. I don't know. If it was clear, if you want to ask me another question on this, I'm happy to answer.
Absolutely. No, that was extremely clear and really seems like quite the impressive solutions. I know you have both the Crafter piece, which is, like you said, the conversational AI, and Portrait, which is more that emotional analysis. And I know you had mentioned there that, you know, it can be applied to customer service, to HR. But just wondering, what specific use cases are driving the most value with Athics?
Well, first of all, thank you for mentioning the name of the solution. I didn't want to, so I really appreciate it. And well, we have many use cases. I would say that on the conversational AI, so crafter.ai solution, we're kind of cross-industry and cross-function. So on the conversational AI, anyone that is listening to us that may be in the marketing, in the customer service, in the operations, in sales, digital sales, e-commerce, HR, can benefit from a use case. So it's really, really cross and it's very, really flexible adaptation to any use case in terms of functions and in terms of industries as well. Let me say that financial services, retailers, and also manufacturing on the B2B side, as well as the B2C side. So like, you know, producer of food, fashions, etc., are really, really benefiting from this kind of solution because they can, reduce cost on managing a relationship with clients and employees, and really having and providing a good experience to their interactions to clients. And on the emotion side, I would say that we are a little more specific because there are three main use cases we can mention here where the impact is like two digits percentage improvement in terms of conversion rate, reduction of cost, or impact on the business in general. First example, customer service. I mentioned it before, like, you know, one of the most important aspect that a company and a service-based company mainly is, very attentive to monitor is the churn. So to retain the customer base, making sure that the customer base keeps on renewing or keeps on buying their products or services. So making sure that you can detect and monitor this in a proactive way, making sure that you target all these persons that have a higher risk of, you know, leaving your service and abandoning you. Well, this is kind of an impact that from 1% in churn rate reduction, which is a big number, Sounds small, but it's 1% churn reduction has impact of millions on the top line of a client, of a business. Another example is at marketing or advertising, making sure that you communicate with the right level of communication style with your audience makes marketing campaign more effective by 50%. And we, tested it with social advertising, with Facebook campaign, with other type of campaign. It really works, and you can have, like for instance, on e-commerce, an impact on from 7 to 12% on the amount of the e-commerce cart. So it's really some big impact on the top line, top results, and so revenues of clients. And finally, HR, as I was mentioning, not only training, as the example I was saying before, but also on the recruitment. So making sure that when you recruit, and maybe in a very early stage career situation. So, boys and girls coming out from a university, for instance, and they don't have a big experience. So, they don't usually have hard skills, but they may have very strong soft skills, but it's very difficult to detect them. And detecting them, you can only do it by, submitting to them a psychoattitudinal test, which is very costly. Just to give you an idea, it's between 200 and 500 euros per each test to be submitted, analyzed, and obtained. So, having this solution can allow you to, at the very first stage of the selection process, to detect the most important soft skill for you and making sure that those people are not taken out from the selection process. Then, of course, this is not the only element you have to evaluate. This is a complement. It's because it's going to go to complement your process of evaluating the schools and the level of studies and maybe other experiences, the age, whatever you want to evaluate for your selection. But then you can integrate it with some soft skill analysis, which is kind of very valuable. On the conversational AI, it's very important to note that we are more and more going on with voice bot, so telephone-based virtual assistant. WhatsApp is growing a lot, so conversational commerce via WhatsApp, engaging clients on the in the hospitality market, for instance, restaurants, hotels, cruises, so pre-boarding, onboarding, and all the process of maintaining a relationship, and lasting the time, not only when the client is at the restaurant, for instance, or in the hotel or in the shop buying your shoes, but being able to keep and extend the relationship also after he or she leaves your service product or shop. So this is kind of, more generic application.
That's great. I know you had just mentioned really the applicability of these solutions to be used across a wide range of industries. So just wondering, how do you exactly define your market? Who are your target customers within these industries?
That's a great question. Most, I would say, I'm not talking about competition, but most of conversational AI and emotion AI companies, vendors like us, target the big guys, all right? So the very, very large corporation. We do have few clients in this area, but our sweet spot and the, that really, really matches with our vision of making innovation accessible goes very well with the mid-market and small and mid-market companies, because these companies usually don't have the resources to, set up a project for creating a chatbot to, they don't have maybe the competencies internally to develop a solution with artificial intelligence. They don't have also the budget to pay maybe for a system integrator to put all together all these solutions. So what we did is to create this platform, which is ready to use, is off the shelf. You just go there and you can do it yourself. I mean, it's kind of self-service. Of course, we can support, because sometimes even if this organization is smaller than the big guys, the corporation, they like and they appreciate to have some support. So what happens usually is that they start with us, and so with a small project, and then they go themselves because we train them, and we don't want to stay there to do projects continuously. We just want them to, you know, start up with a chatbot, let's say a voice bot or a WhatsApp chatbot, and then being able to evolve it autonomously. And the platform provides all these characteristics, which is kind of unique because most of the time, platforms require some development grade and level. We don't. We're a full no-code platform.
Amazing. I'm wondering if we can dive a little deeper as well into your AI model. I know you mentioned you leverage some generative AI, but maybe we can just dive deeper into that piece and, you know, learn a little bit more about how your AI works.
Yes, of course. And, you know, you will see during the demo. However, we apply AI in various way. And we decided not to be too, exclusive, but to include also AI technologies, as we try to include various categories of companies, because, AI has a long story since the 50s. So we, you know, picked the best outputs of AI along this many years that where AI is on the market. And so we integrate three types of artificial intelligence. We, of course, leverage on generative AI. We leverage on machine learning, natural language processing, which is the core of our platform. And then we also leverage on rule-based models, which in some occasion, in some situation, even though is a very old, let's say, technology, is very effective in some processes, in some situations. So what we decided to do is not to choose on behalf of our clients what AI they can use, but give them the opportunity to leverage on any kind of AI, generative AI, conversational AI, emotion AI, rule-based AI, natural language processing, machine learning, to making sure that they can exploit the maximum values from these technologies in a very, very simple way, which is our leitmotiv. I mean, we prefer not to do something if it's not easy for our client. And the platform, I mean, we will show it to you in a while. So generative AI, we leverage it in, for instance, for shortening time and speed up the process of creating a very powerful knowledge base. So we leverage on a generative AI, large language models, to do that, so that you don't have to create your own Q&A, FAQs, etc. But you can just put some material, maybe documents, maybe websites, links, whatever, in the platform, and the platform will elaborate on it for you. So you save a lot of time. This was before generative AI was becoming mainstream. I would say 60% of the time, if you wanted to do a good job in terms of knowledge base. Then we leverage a rule based on the flow. So we have a flow designer technology, which is very different from the ones that you have been seeing before, because it's a flow designer that allows you to associate a single flow, a process. I want to change my shoes that I bought. So I go to the chatbot, I say, want to change my shoes. And the chatbot guides you through a process, a predefined process, which generative AI cannot do, but has to be rule-based, because you define the rules, you define the question you have to ask the clients, maybe your address, maybe the type of shoes they bought, why they want to change it, etc. And you can guide it in a very visualized way. You can create it. And you create processes by intent. So each intent, each questions and answer in your knowledge base, each item of your knowledge base can be associated to a single process. So you don't have to create a huge graph of, you know, tree decision trees, but you just have smaller ones associated only to the intent that require a process. If they don't require, there's going to be a single and simple answer. This is another impact in terms of usability. And, you know, this impacts a lot in terms of evolution and management of the platform. Because if you have to change something, you don't have to change this huge tree, but you go and change only the single intent is affected by this change in terms of your process. Maybe you don't want anymore to send DHL to pick up the shoes to the house to the client, and it's the client that has to go to the DHL store to ship it and everything. So you can change it very, very quickly. And fine. Yeah, sorry. Go ahead.
Oh, sorry. No, I didn't mean to cut you off. Please continue.
No. And all this is wrapped up with our machine learning natural language processing capabilities, and that always stay tuned to making sure that the answer is the best possible answer offered to the client. All this is a supervised model. Again, we don't let generative AI answering what they want. We just control it. That's what I was mentioning before, risk-free, because there's no risk that generative AI invents something or is hallucinated.
That's great. And actually, that's why I almost cut you off. I wanted to ask about how exactly you keep your platform risk-free. You used that great example of the issue with Air Canada and their chatbot, like you said, kind of, I don't want to say lying to a customer, maybe misleading, maybe lying to a customer, and, you know, Air Canada having to deal with that issue. So maybe can we expand on that a bit more? How exactly are you able to avoid the risks that are associated with this area of AI?
Yes, it was a little bit on what I said before, but the point, basic point, is that the human is always at the center, and human, so the manager that is creating his own chatbot, always control what's happening. And this is very important. You know, as you know, generative AI is a process of statistical process that puts one word after another, all right? And you don't control, you don't even know what was answered if you have, unless you go and read all the scripts, all the conversation that took place with your clients. What we do is we reversed all this. And so we decided that in the platform, you create your own knowledge base. You check the knowledge base, meaning you check all the answers, maybe 100, 200, 300. This is the number. It's not like 5,000. It's very difficult to achieve those numbers, because even big corporations don't arrive to that. I mean, once you have 200 question and answer item of knowledge base, you probably covered most of the company in the world, even the bigger ones. Once you have that and you control them, and this is supervised, so you know exactly what the question or the intent or the topic related to that and what has to be answered, then generative AI goes in a parametric database and pick up the things, making sure that you don't go too far away from that. And this is how we do it. And this is how we can pick up pieces of answers and put them together, all, you know, related to the same topic. The most important, the test you can do is that you can ask maybe to someone that produces cups, a question on cups that is on the knowledge base, and the chatbot will answer. Then you ask them, what was the last president of the United States? And even though we are using large language model, that question is not even covered and in the knowledge base. And the answer will be, I'm not allowed to provide any information outside my knowledge base. That's it. So the risk is very reduced, because when the chatbot and the natural language processing platform recognize an answer that is already in the knowledge base, uses that answer or a piece of the answer, but doesn't create a new answer. That's, you know, the guarantee that you don't go outside. And on the other hand, you can manage multiple intents, you can manage question asked in different ways, and that's not a problem, because there will be reconducted to the original knowledge base, and the answer will be that one every time. No inventing.
Absolutely. No, that sounds amazing. And I know we'd mentioned that you have a demo prepared and that we could dive a little deeper into the platform. But do you think we could pull that up now and see how this all works?
Of course, of course. Very happy to. I'll hand over to David.
Yes, let me share my screen. Okay, we will start the live demonstration with a simulation of a conversation between a chatbot that is built with Crafter and a client. And in this case, we can see the answer of a simple question, and the chatbot picked the answer within the knowledge base. But if needed, the chatbot is able to to start a guided step-by-step process to help the client through a troubleshooting path, asking to do actions such as in this example, this is troubleshooting, and asking to do the action required to resolve the issue. But if necessary, for instance, there is a problem and no answer, the process, the chatbot asks the client if they need to be passed to a live agent to continue the investigating the problem. In this case, the conversation is passed to a live agent, and in this case, the agent is manages the conversation within the handover console on Crafter platform. While the agent is having a conversation with the client, the platform sends tips to the agent as well. And in this case, the agent is able to use tips performed sent by platform to answer the client, or send directly answers to the clients without editing them. This is an example of a real-life conversation between the client and the chatbot, or a live agent, and how Crafter platform helps to create a greater user experience. Now we're gonna see how the platform helps the manager. Crafter provides a simple and easy to use wizard to guide users through a process of managing their own chatbot. Here we can see how to manage the knowledge base, increase and create knowledge base, for instance, using texts, documents, or URL, for instance, like this. In this example, I'm using this URL to extract text, analyze the text there is within this page. And in this case, I'm using the generative AI to automatically generate the expected questions and answers. For each topic, this is the output of the elaboration performed by the generative AI, and these are the questions and answers found out by the generative AI. In this case, building my knowledge base, I can associate to each intent a conversational flow directly within each intent. Here, for example, I can build my own process and full base or a process that helps and guides the clients through a process, and I can decide to end the process, the flow, engaging, for instance, a live agent, or call an additional question, like Paolo said before. I can associate another intent to be requested at the end of this process, and the conversation move on to that additional question. Or I can ask to call a communication with a third-party application via API, and we created a Postman-like platform to interface to create and configure the API calls. And this is the example how this platform, our platform, can help the manager to create the knowledge base. Next step is how Crafter helps managers to improve the chatbot performance, and the platform is able to recognize a missed topic and give the bot ability to manage it. Managing misses, I can associate the missed topic to an intent already existing within the knowledge base, or create a new one topic, for instance. In this case, after that, The next step is obviously the training of the knowledge and the capability of the chapter to understand what I have within my my knowledge base, and the training is very easy and fast. It's not needed to have a developer or data scientist competence. Just one click and you launch the process of training. The next step is the test of our chatbot, and here you can test and you can decide to modify the chat room appearance, making it to aligned to your corporate communication guidelines or to your website. The next step, and this is a very quick and easy process, is the development. The deployment of the modified and or updated chatbot is already easy, and you have to press only one button to update in every channel that where the chatbot is viewed, and in only one button you can update everywhere your chatbot. Also, you have the possibility to create a new page and publish the chatbot in another web page only with a copy and paste of this code within your web page. This is the first topic of this part of the demo. In this case, platform provides a powerful analysis environment, and here you can gain valuable insights into your chatbot interactions, allowing you to optimize and improve the customer experience. This is Crafter. The second part of the demo is Portrait. Imagine to having the chance to know in advance the possible behavior of user, customers, employees, or partners, and to be able to anticipate the right actions to close a sales deal, to increase the success of your marketing, to improve the best customer service, or identify the best candidate of your job opening. In this today, I'm going to introduce you to Portrait, the psychometric profiling solution designed to predict behavior of people and enabling businesses to pick up the best next action in real time while talking to clients or employees more. The application has three main uses: customer service, while talking to clients, we can adapt in real time the most effective nested back selection based on clients' attitudes. For example, propose an extension of the guarantee only to the person that have a high propensity to be protected by risks. In marketing, we can analyze the target audience in order to enable a fully aligned communication style. In HR, either for high volume recruitment scenarios where you have hundreds of candidates to screen and map in employees' soft skills or competence and define more effective training and employee courses offering. In this example, I'm going to show an example in HR environment, and let me show how Portrait analyzes a short text. It needs about only 300 characters to that is about 50 words. And imagine, in this case, imagine to have an applicant that is applying for a junior marketing position. In the application form on our website, for example, we can ask to write a few sentences about the topic of our choice, no matter the topic. It can be, for example, the last book they read or the preferred vacation location. We just need them to provide us a short written text written by themselves. And in this case, we analyze Sorry, maybe I have to. Maybe I have to re-log in.
Yes, the demo effect.
Yeah, the demo effect. Okay. Okay, perfect. And as you can see, Portrait is able to elaborate the psychometric profile of the subject and provide us with valuable insight to additional elements in order to more accurately evaluate the candidates. In this example, Portrait has elaborated the candidate psychometric profile and listed the most relevant propensity of that they have. For instance, this subject has a logical communication style. He is open to innovation. His group task proficiency has group task proficiency. But if we need to find a specific behavior of the analyzed subject, we can create a personalized aggregate trait using the correlation matrices. Here you can easily create several labels for each skill you need to map, and Portrait will be able to label the match skill to each profiling. Here you have the traits that you have to detect and match in the profile of the analyzed person, and then you can create your own aggregate trait. This is in our example, we can identify, for example, the candidates who align with my organization values and requirement, for example, innovation propensity or team working attitude. Portrait can also be integrated with large language models, allowing us to ask specific questions and receive tailored guidance. For example, let's say that we want to determine if the candidate is suitable for the junior marketing manager position, and we want to know which question to ask in the next interview. And simply ask to the LLM the guidance, we have the answer. And here, the LLM provide me the answer that this candidate profile suggests that is suitable for the junior marketing manager position. And here, these are the questions that I have, three questions, for example, to ask during the next interview. Let me show an example, a real example, for instance, this one. Okay, here, this is an actual example of how we can use Portrait during an application. Here, this is, we have replied a website where there are some positions, and here I am beginning an application. In addition to the question that I have to provide, example, my name, my surname, and the email. Okay, this is the required questions. I have the hard skill questions, but in this case, I provided to the candidate to ask something about himself using free text. In this example, I applied. Oh, I already used this email. This is a check. Okay. Okay. Perfect. Now I applied to this, and in this case, Portrait enable me to screen the applicant and know how the results, knowing if the label that are given to each applicant, and that match the soft skill, and I can use the large language model to have suggestions for the next interview. In conclusion, Portrait offers a comprehensive solution for analyzing subjects' psychometric profiles, creating correlation matrices, and leveraging advanced large language model assistance to enhance, for example, your hiring process. And this is the example of the how to use this this solution.
Oh, that's amazing. Thank you for that, David. I think one thing that really stood out to myself watching that anyway was the user interface and how easy it seemed really to move from one step to the other, and even to train the conversational AI agent with Crafter AI there. So just curious, maybe as a natural follow-up there, how technical do users need to be to use this solution? Was I kind of accurate in sensing that anyone can really pick it up and work with it?
Yes, this is our idea, is just to make it simple, quick, and making people autonomous on using all this solution. For instance, if a big corporation has already, on the example of Portrait, the last one we just saw, and David demoed, they already have their own recruitment solution, they can just integrate via API our solution. Easy. But in another case, maybe a smaller organization, they don't have a typical SAP SuccessFactors solution or others, they can leverage our pre-prepared and pre-created application just to put them on their websites, and leveraging all this that you have seen in, I would say, a couple of weeks is going to be up and running, no problem. So really no need to be technical. Of course, there may be some support to integrate, if there is the need, third-party systems. So if you want to integrate your CRM, if you want to integrate other system, of course, we have connectors you can leverage on, but some level of understanding of that area may be required. So let me say that usually mid-sized company have someone that is taking care of IT within their company. I'm thinking about company with 30, 40, 50 million dollars or euros of revenues per year. They definitely have at least one person that takes care of IT. So, I mean, this usually is not really a problem, and they go just themselves. However, they, even if they don't have someone that can take care of IT, they can do it self-service by via our website, or again, asking our support, not for the developing side, but more for the processing, and to, you know, speed up all the process and making sure that they are confident on moving on the process. That's only a matter of being more confident rather than being able to.
Absolutely. And wondering if we could dive a little deeper into what you're hearing from your clients in terms of where they're receiving the most benefits. Is it time saved? Is it dollar saved? What are you hearing in that sense?
All right. For the HR perspective, I mean, let's go through the use cases. From the HR perspective, we measured a 30 to 50% reduction on onboarding processes. So people, once they sign, they are recruited. There are a number of administrative tasks to be performed by the HR partner. We can cut that time by 30 to 50%, which is a lot. The experience just improved a lot by the people that interact with these tools. On the customer service, we measured a reduction of cost between 40 to 70% in terms of operations for the customer service activities. And these costs are related to training of new people. As you see, have you seen the platform can support the answer of a live operator, a live agent. So you don't need to train everybody, because the platform will support live agents to provide the right answers, for instance. Of course, you're going to be managing peaks of requests without having to hire people, maybe external people that don't know your business. So you will have to train these new people maybe just for December, because you're in hotel and you're going to have a request for in the customer service channel because people going on holidays, for instance, just an example. So seasonality, you can manage it very, very quickly and easily. And you don't have to hire people or acquire external services to cover this peak of requests. And so these were the cost sits. And of course, the best thing is that the impact on clients is very, very high, because you have a 24/7 operating system that helps you providing any answer to your clients. And if the answer is something that in a way is not covered by the knowledge base, because if you don't insert something in the knowledge base, you won't be, the chatbot won't be able to answer because it doesn't invent. That's very important. You can get a lead and maybe follow up on the client the following day. So getting the name, the telephone number or the email to follow up with the client, making sure that this specific client will get the answer they were looking for. So this is a way of really making clients, prospects, and you know, any, all the ecosystem appear. And yes, on the marketing side, as I was mentioning, the impact on campaigns is very high. I mentioned the social advertising, but also landing page, dynamic landing page. Instead of having this old style landing page, you can have a chatbot landing page and having the chatbot answering whatever. And you know that those clients are coming from a specific advertising. So you know what the topic was hooking them. So you mm-hmm. can just go straight forward on the topic and making sure that you push on something, if this is what you want to do in terms of sales. So sales, digital sales, e-commerce, all they can benefit from all these applications.
Right. And taking just a brief look into the future, obviously I appreciate the insight into what Athix is currently able to offer with Crafter.ai and Portrait. But just wondering, what's your roadmap look like? How do you see these platforms growing in, say, the next year or 3 years?
Well, first of all, we are working a lot of on multimodality, so this is going to be one of our direction. So making sure that we can get as an input voice, text, images, etc. So in the next few years, this is going to be covered fully. At the moment, we cover voice, we cover text, but we can extend this. The other part that is ongoing on our R&D is making sure that we offer a very simple experience and pleasant experience. So this is where I would say at least 30 to 40% of our resource every day look at, because there's always something to do better in order to making sure that the experience our clients are living is perfect. And when I say clients, I mean all the people that stay behind the chatbot and needs to use it to, you know, make sure that the chatbot will answer correctly to their clients, to their employees, or to their prospects. So these are the two main areas of work. Then we are really working very hard on making sure that all the analytics are automated in order to support decision making. This is another area where we are working a lot. As you have seen, we already have analytics within the platform. We can, you know, work a lot. And then, of course, integrating with other platforms, which already we do, like the Dynamic, Salesforce, etc. But extending this coverage to, again, the objective is making sure that with one click, you can really easily operate within your system and without having any competencies or any knowledge in terms of developer, in terms of IT skills or technical skills.
That's great. The future does seem really bright. Even that in the present, hearing about all the use cases, you're able to cover all the benefits you bring your clients. It really is just proof that, you know, companies like Athix are out there and are able to deliver great value in the world of AI. So Paolo, David, I just want to thank you again, both so much for taking the time to join us here today and for sharing your insights in this interview here.
Thank you, Austin, and have fun with the artificial intelligence.